Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Jane Salisbury and Melissa Madenski, who are the, I'm doing this from memory now, who are the supervisor for outreach, supervisor for outreach programs.
Library outreach services,
yes. Multnomah County Library, and adult literacy coordinator, Multnomah County
Perfect.
Library. All right, it's really, by next week, I'm going to have this down. We talked about library materials and services going out to people who are incarcerated. And you also mentioned people who are homebound, and I'm assuming that's not like in the Paul Simon sense of being homebound. That is people
not,
who are
not
there
on their way home.
Just
no,
not able to get out for whatever reason.
Yeah.
What does homebound mean, first of all? That has a lot of covers a lot of different things, I would imagine.
Homebound really means anyone who has, to us, means anyone who has a really significant barrier to getting to the library, whether that's for reasons of a physical disability or age or illness or a mental condition like agoraphobia or a temporary condition like a difficult pregnancy or a couple broken legs
or
whatever.
I just can't tear myself away from the supercomputer on Jeopardy.
Leaving your No, that
halftime show was great. I can't be bothered.
Okay. We hardly ever deny anyone, but that we have to say no to that.
How many people are using these services on a monthly or year basis?
Well,
is there any way to even tell?
I think we have about 100 homebound individuals that we're serving right now, and then we serve about 30 different large residences like. Retirement homes and public housing, large high rises, where we bring library service into them. So there's lots of people in those 30 institutions that we serve. And then we bring collections to various assisted livings and day programs, treatment programs, kind of a variety of places.
Any way to tell me how many languages the library currently offers materials in now? I mean, it must just
Well,
be...
you know, what's really interesting is that in the past, maybe 10 years or so, we've really honed down the number of languages that we do provide materials in order to provide what we call a target language program. We really want to serve the largest target, the largest language groups in Multnomah County, and that in our book is Spanish, Russian, Chinese, and Vietnamese. And we're looking at some at Somali also as another language because there's a significant number of Somali immigrants in Portland, but really the bulk of our materials are purchased in those languages. And it's what's interesting is that several of the places that we actually visit, retirement places, have, I think a lot of people think of immigrants as younger families or younger people, but there are lots of older immigrants who also don't necessarily learn English. They come here so much later in life that we're providing materials for Chinese speakers, Russian speakers, some Spanish speakers at several of the places that we visit to lots older immigrants.
The Esperanto section, though, probably had to be scaled down.
Yes. When I first came to the library, we did have some books in
Really?
Esperanto. Yes, but they're gone now, I think.
You ever seen that film that William Shatner made in Esperanto? I swear to God, I'm not making it up.
But I can't wait.
I got a copy at home.
Yeah.
You mentioned something during the break that that astounded me, and you said this wasn't even the complete number. You said the library services 50 different shelters, and I'm assuming that's all different kinds of shelters.
All different kinds of shelters, yes.
Battered women shelters, homeless shelters. That is, so 50. That's not 50 total. That's 50 that the library services.
That's the 50 that we serve.
I had no idea there were even 50 shelters. I mean, maybe I sound daft or naive, but I had no idea that were that many. That's astounding.
It's a pretty sad fact that, and it surprises me every time I see it or say it. That we serve that many places, and some of them are small places, and some of them are more like day shelter kinds of places. But so everywhere from large places like transition projects or to smaller domestic violence.
I'm going to, as they say, put a pin in this, and we will come back and we will finish this discussion on this on the other side. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. We are talking about the Multnomah County Library System. Stay right there. We're back momentarily.